In the previous video, we calculated the highest possible profit by changing the amount of sugar in our lemonade. But for that, we needed to use a lot of space on the Excel sheet. And also, we needed to do lots of thinking. What is the formula? How do I add the data table? Add conditional formatting? And I promised you that we would let Excel do the thinking instead of us. So in this video, I will make it even easier for you to find the highest profit using a tool in Excel called the Solver. And the solver is already built into Excel. However, before you can use it, you first have to enable it. This is how it looks like. We go to the options of Excel. Then we go to add-ins and we click Excel add-ins. And there it is, the solver. We just have to tick it and then it appears right there. We don't have to reboot Excel. We can immediately use it because it's now enabled. So what does the solver do? The solver is a little bit like GoalSeek, but it's more powerful because we're not just saying we look for a goal. We can maximize or minimize values and take multiple cells into account. So let's see how that looks like. We're going to delete these cells. We don't need the data table anymore because we will directly get the right value. We click Solver. There we go. And now we can say what is the cell that we want to analyze, that cell. And we want to set it to maximum by changing the value of sugar. So you see it's quite similar to GoalSeek. In the background, let me remove that, you already got the value. See that? Bam! Immediately it happened there, right in front of our eyes. We got the maximum value 120 and something, it's very precise. We didn't need a data table, we didn't need conditional formatting, we didn't need extra room on the Excel sheet, we just got the value immediately. Isn't that nice? And the solver is even better than that, because we can do more powerful things. Let's have a look at what we can do as well. We can also change the water and the lemons. We don't need to restrict ourselves to just one value of sugar as with the GoalSeek. Here we can actually use multiple cells. So we can say change water and change lemons too. We again get a solution. However, we now have zero for water and zero for lemons. Let's not do that. Let's revert back to the old values. If the solver solves something that you don't want, you can always use this option to go back to whatever you had before you ran the solver. So you don't have to be afraid that the solver will mess with your entire spreadsheet, because you can always check this option and it will reset everything. So this is not what we wanted, zero lemons and zero water. What we wanted is something more realistic. Solver can help us with that because we can add constraints, which are rules that the solver has to listen to. For example, we could say the lemons have to be at least 3 lemons and the water has to be at least 3 times the amount of sugar, because otherwise it will be very strange lemonade. So if we set these rules, the solver will find the solution within those rules. So what we get now, as you can see, is unfortunately, exactly 3 times the amount of sugar and exactly 3 lemons. And that's of course not that strange, because the rule we have for the expected sales only depends on the sugar. So whatever we do with water and lemons is not of effect. So for the homework this week, you are going to change that. We will give you a new formula for expected sales, taking water and lemons into account. And then it's your goal to use the solver to find the perfect lemonade. Good luck!